Bezrat Hashem, with Hashem's love and grace, welcome to Amuna Beams with your host, Laser Broody. Today's podcast is entitled, A Most Welcome Guest, and it's a poignant thought to give us a proper perspective for coping with life's challenges in general, and preparing for Lag BaOmer in particular, as well as to invoke every single blessing for you and your family. Think of this parable. There was a righteous family that lived in dire poverty in a Ukrainian hamlet, what we call a shtetl. One day, just as they were about to partake of their meager Shabbos evening meal, they heard knocking at the door. The head of the household, he opened the door and saw a group of glowing elders who looked just like angels, smiling from ear to ear, and he asked them who they were. Well, the first one introduced himself and said, I'm Emuna, pure and complete faith in Hashem. The second one, he introduced himself and he said, I'm Simcha, happiness in life. And the third one came forward and introduced himself and he says, I'm Parnassa, a good income. Well, the fourth one, he came and introduced himself and he says, I'm Gesund, good health. The fifth one introduced himself and he says, my name is Nachas, joy from your children. Well, the poor man said, welcome to my home. Please sit down with us for our Shabbos meal. We have wine and we have challah, but we don't have much else. But it would be an honor to share whatever we have with such distinguished guests as you. No, they said in unison, you must choose which one of us you want. We told you who we are, but only one of us is allowed to come inside your home. Ooh, if that's the case, said the poor man, I must consult with my wife and children. So he turned to his family and he says, look at the miracles at our doorstep. Look at the beautiful smiles. If we want, we can have happiness, we can have nachas, we can have good health, we can have parnasa, we can have emuna. Which do you want? Well, the whole family agreed that emuna was the guest they wanted to invite inside. Well, when emuna entered the house, all the other guests came in as well. The poor man said, I only thought that one of you was allowed to enter. Well, they replied happily, true, but if you would have chosen anyone other than Emuna, then only one of us could come inside. But since you chose Emuna, we all follow, because we always follow Emuna. He's our leader. The parable has a deep lesson to it. If you have Emuna, you have every blessing in life. The family in our parable, they already had Emuna if they were willing to share the little what they had in life with these five guests. In fact, it was their wonderful outlook that invoked a visit from angels in the first place. Their poverty and suffering were certainly not easy, but it uplifted them. By the same token, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai's deprivation, hiding in a cave for 13 years after being chased by the Romans that wanted to kill him, and then living on carobs and water for 13 whole years while learning Torah in a cave, that's what made him Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Not only is there no contradiction between suffering and emunah, suffering enhances emunah when we have to cope with difficulties in life. Because people with easy lives, they don't feel the stimulation or the need to turn to Hashem. But with the real emunah, we can thank Hashem for the life's challenges. In that respect, the coronavirus is really an angel from Hashem, because it too is Hashem's emissary to help us strengthen our emunah, to turn to Him with more fervor, and to strengthen our trust that no one can help us but Hashem. And it's all designed from a loving Father in heaven to bring us closer to Him, when we too will see every blessing of good health, adequate income, joy, and much nachas. You just wait and see, because all those blessings are fast on the way. Amen. Happy Lag BaOmer.